Is this the best hotel in Miami?
Let's go check out the rest of the lobby. There it is.
Welcome to the Deluxe City View King.
I've got a single glass.
So it's actually pretty big.
What is that?
Whoa.
Oh, wow. Where are our bags?
I don't know if you can see it yet, but let's go take a look.
We're here at the Miami Beach Edition, and we're about to find out.
Let's check in and check it out. Let's go. So right when you walk in the Miami Beach Edition, you are immediately met with like lush and elegance. There's just trees everywhere, there's monsteras everywhere. You have this beautiful marble floor that's original to the original Seville Hotel. Also original, these marble columns. They've been refinished obviously and renovated, but it's incredible to see this in its almost original form. And it's super elegant. It smells like the aroma in here just makes you feel like luxury. And you know you're about to experience something pretty magical and amazing. It's a place that you really want to spend time in. Like every time we walk in here, I get goosebumps and like, oh my God, this smells amazing. I gotta buy this. And it makes me want to come back. It really does that smell. It's very interesting. I'm literally getting goosebumps right now. The bar is pretty cool. It's not open obviously due to the current situation, but this is definitely a place that I would come hang out. Look at these cloud couches. Come over here, grab a drink from this Art Deco Miami Beach vibe and just chill out on these awesome couches. Just like kind of everywhere else in here, there's little ways you can tuck away and be private and be by yourself, and that's luxury, kind of being able to hide away from everything, the everyday life. Actually, this is real glass. This isn't even plexiglass. This is real glass.
Welcome to the Deluxe City View Room. Let's check it out. It's actually considered a junior suite. So right when you walk in, we have a nice storage closet here with some awesome wallpaper in the back. Very tropical, safe, some storage pullouts here, luggage holder, and a pretty standard setup here. So right after the closet, you walk in and you get to the bar.
So what's interesting about this is that a lot of hotels right now have removed all the drinks and everything due to the COVID situation. And this hotel actually went through the trouble of providing them for the guests. Down below, you'll find a mini fridge. And what I love about this is that everything in here is a high quality item. So from La Colombe coffees and draft lattes to organic coconut waters to Fever Tree ginger ale, Krug champagne if you're feeling festive like we usually are. Everything is in here at your convenience. On the other side here, we also have the high quality products like sunbone, sunscreen. We've got addition gummies. Down below, we've got a single glass.
Actually, saw some other glasses in the bathroom as well. I think it's just an extra.
I was like, one's kind of lonely, you know? Like, I have a good time. All right, so yeah, that's pretty cool. I'm stoked. I've been to a couple hotels now during COVID, and I haven't seen a fully stocked mini fridge or mini bar.
So right when you walk in the room, first thing you notice on the right side is this huge couch. I mean, it looks so fluffy. It looks like that Restoration Hardware cloud couch. Like, I could easily sleep one or two people. Next thing, you walk over here, this huge desk with so much attention to detail. This monstera clipping is real. This is a legit monstera clipping, which is gorgeous, and it goes with the total aesthetic of just minimalism and modern aesthetic. Very light and airy. You have the whites and the almost like beachy type wood, which is just incredible. It all ties totally into the location of being right in the heart of Miami Beach. And then when you look out this window, which is right in front of the desk, is this beautiful view of the city of Miami. I mean, look at that. It's seriously incredible. So another thing we're looking for in a hotel right now, which is super important, is somewhere to eat, takeout. Since, you know, we're in these times right now, we need to be able to take food out, come upstairs and eat. It's kind of a little strange. There's only one chair though. I think we could probably pull up this chair and maybe use this little thing as a chair as well, but it's kind of strange. There's only one chair. This is considered a junior suite, so it's actually pretty big. Come over here, we have the king size bed. Two perfect little nightstands with reading lights on top. And then a huge TV, which is on a swivel, so we're able to move it kind of put it wherever you want. If we want to watch it over on the couch, we can actually sit on the couch and move it. And then we have another view of the city out here. Kind of minimal, but one thing to note is this is the old Civil Hotel, and these are like original tiles on the outside of the hotel. Let's check out the bathroom. I don't know if you guys even noticed when we first walked in, this crazy barn door. It's super thick, very sturdy.
Oh, hey Chris, you wanna do the bathroom tour?
Yeah, so as you guys know, I'm a big stickler for privacy, and the first thing I love is this massive, strong, and solid wood door that completely blocks this bathroom off. Why don't you come on in? So we've got this incredible minimalistic sink with LED backlighting and the mirrors. We've got these very high-end Labo soaps, a nice grow faucet. I'm a stickler for little things around the house too. And even down to the drain itself is minimalistic. It's, you don't have the traditional center drain, you've got this very sleek modern design. Down below we find plenty of towels for the guests. There's a shower cap, there's a loofah pad, vanity kit, tissues, more glasses on a nice bench, also a mirror for doing your makeup. Again, and also this doubled as a stool. So first class all the way in here, water closet. Hooks for towels, this is missing in a lot of places after you shower, especially if you have a couple guests in a room. It's nice to be able to know whose towels who. Moving on, we found the tub. Didn't know we're getting a full tub. Again, very nice, a private little nook for the tub. It's probably echoing like crazy in here. And then down here, surprisingly, yet another vanity.
Whoa.
Set up exactly the same way with all the same amenities. Over here, we've got a shower that should pass anyone's shower test.
Definitely does.
Very high polar fixtures in here, a lower wand as well. And again, there's Edition branded Labo soaps, which I love. In fact, we're gonna have to send some more out because I need some.
We all need some.
And then behind here, we have another closet for more storage, some ropes to wear down in the spa or the pool deck with that really appropriately fitting wallpaper in the back. Very tropical, it just sets the mood, sets the vibe. Okay, so this is the Deluxe City View King Room here at the Miami Beach Edition. Now we're gonna go check out what they call the backyard, the pool and the beach. Let's go.
Let's see what else comes.
You walk out from the lobby and you have this wonderful little terrace here. And again, lush, everything is lush. There are plants and trees everywhere. And you see just little peaks through the plants and you see the pool, super blue. And this is actually a pretty famous pool because we have this Art Deco structure that used to be diving boards. I don't know if you can see it yet, but let's go take a look. So when the pool opens, there's an attendant here and they give out sunscreen and drinks and towels and everything. They gave out even lens cloths for your sunglasses, you know, because it gets a little oily with sunscreen sometimes. They have everything covered here at the Edition.
So we have two very nice pools here at the Miami Beach Edition. The first one is the modern pool. This is one that they built when they renovated this property, which was the Seville, as Alex mentioned. And it's a pretty nice, very modern lap pool. You'll see a lot of photos. This is where a lot of people hang out and spend their day enjoying the sun down here in South Beach. Over here on the right, though, there's the historic Eden Rock pool. And this structure here used to actually be two diving boards back in the 50s during the original Seville Hotel era. And in fact, behind us here, well, it used to be cabanas that people would come down to Miami from like the Northeast and New York, rent out for the day or whatever, and hang out here in this great location. What I love about this pool is that they have rooms right up adjacent to it in the cabana bungalows. And so if you're with a family and you got the lower level, you could essentially have great access to the pool, just something for everyone here. Okay, so if you've had enough fun in the sun here in the pool area, you can step right over here and explore the beach. If you're hungry, you've got Tropical over here, which opens at 11 a.m. daily for food and drinks.
We've got these black grouper tacos. They're so moist and flaky, and there's this aioli sauce that is just like insane. Jesus hooked us up with this special smoky barbecue sauce that they have. If you're here, you have to get this barbecue sauce. It's homemade, which is, it's insane. It's the most smokiest barbecue sauce I've ever had, in a good way.
It looks incredible. Can we eat now?
Let's eat. Also the fries. They're so crispy.
As well as a Matador Terrace, which is over here above the modern pool.
Crispy.
So you've got plenty of options here for whatever brings you to South Florida and however you want to enjoy your lovely day and stay at the Miami Beach Edition. Okay, we're gonna take you to a secret spot above Tropical to tell you what we think about the Miami Beach Edition. And then after that, we're gonna go have some fun in the sun and check out the beach. Let's go. Love this hotel.
Yeah, this is insane.
So much love.
This is crazy. It's a little like observation deck on top of Tropical.
This is the secret spot. We don't tell anyone about this one.
Wow, look at that ocean view. Look at that.
I could just spend days here relaxing at this hotel.
From on top of Tropical, you could see the ocean, the beach, both pools, and we have these nice little cushions here. Maybe come up, have a drink, hang out. Really, this is even more exclusivity. You're all alone up here. No one is up here.
All right, so we've spent a full day here at the Miami Beach Edition. What do you think? What was your experience? You got here first. What was your experience?
As soon as we got here, we got our welcome drink. We were met with just pure luxury, lush inside lobby. I mean, everyone was super nice.
The lobby smells incredible. So the second you get in, you just can tell. All your senses start tingling. Like, this is going to be a great experience off the bat.
Yeah, and the bellhop came over, grabbed all our bags, put them right on our cart, wanted to get us drinks, wanted to get us up to our room. They gave us early check-in.
Yeah, early check-in at 11:30 on a holiday weekend here at the Miami Beach Edition. Incredible.
Yeah, that's unlike the last South Beach experience we had.
We got to the room. It was amazing, very clean.
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly what it was pictured.
Pictured was exactly what we got. Yeah. And you got a beautiful view, a way bigger couch than we assumed, and the bed was massive. The bathroom was perfect for three people, really. Yeah,
really.
Could have had four people.
Easily. And then we explored the hotel. There are two pools. We actually spent the whole day here. We ate lunch at Tropical, which is delicious. Those black grouper tacos look fire.
Oh my God. That's something to note. Here, this property is so massive that you don't really need to leave.
Normally when we're traveling, yeah, we do go explore the city, but this time, since we're from Miami, yes, we decided to go ahead and spend our day here.
Well, there's the three restaurants, so you can kind of pick and choose where you want to go for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Now, the menus are limited due, yes, to the current COVID situation, but they're still delicious.
Mm-hmm.
So then after we ate lunch, we went, enjoyed the beach a little bit, swam in the pool, popped over, got ready for dinner, went to Matador for dinner, which, yes, is here. Matador service could be improved. It was a very long dinner. That would be my one critique there.
The
mojito was incredible. I think this hotel is the best mojito in Miami. Now, on the notes of best things, I also, yeah, think the Miami Beach Edition is the best hotel in South Beach right now. So if you're looking for a very nice, yeah, very luxurious stay, this is the place to be. And not a lot of people are talking about it.
I was about to cut you off and say, I think this is the best hotel in Miami Beach right now. Absolutely. Hands down, there's really nothing else to say. The service, the quality, the room size, the amenities, the pool, the beach, you have everything here.
There are a lot of incredible hotels down here in South Beach, and we can't wait to explore them all. But right now, this Miami Beach Edition is the best hotel in Miami. Yeah,
absolutely.
All right, let's go get a drink.
Yeah.
Go.
This.